another tutorial on LTSpice. In my last tutorial, you have seen that I have discussed the design flow of Weinbridge oscillator, but here I am going to discuss the design flow for the phase shift oscillator. In a similar way that I have achieved the condition of oscillation as well as I have built up the RC network to achieve the desired frequency response for the Weinbridge oscillator, here also I will show you how we can build up an RC network so that we can achieve the desired frequency response as well as how we can achieve the condition of oscillation for the phase shift oscillator. So without spending much time, let's go to the design interface of the LTSpice. Well, so this is the circuit diagram that I have drawn for the Weinbridge oscillator in my last tutorial. The same circuit diagram I'm going to use for designing the phase shift oscillators because I just need to rearrange a few circuits if I reuse the previous circuit. So that's why I'm going to just change this one. I just need to change only these RC network because the frequency of oscillations that is achieved using this RC network, which is different for this Weinbridge oscillator when I compare with the phase shift oscillator. And I'm just placing it away from the main circuit region. And now I'm maintaining the ratio of R2 by R1 for the time being, and while I'm just drawing the RC network for the phase shift oscillator. Okay, so in case of phase shift oscillator, as we know that the three RC section is used in general, but you can use more than three RC section or even less than the three RC section. Each RC section offers you 60 degree phase shift if you use the three RC sections. So as a whole, the total three RC section will offer you 180 degree phase shift. The detailed theory of the phase shift oscillator is available in my lecture series on analog circuits. You can go through over there. The link is available in the description box. And here I'm connecting the three RC sections. And I'm removing this ground terminal and connecting it to over here. And unlike the Weinbridge oscillator, where the feedback was directly connected with the non-inverting terminal, here the feedback is connected with the inverting terminal through this resistor R1. This is the one of the difference between the phase shift and RC oscillator, phase shift and Weinbridge oscillator. So there are many differences I will discuss over here. Anyway, so this is the basic circuit we generally see in textbooks. But there's a difference, there's a problem with while you are using this particular circuit in practical circuit. The problem is in case of the phase shift oscillator, each RC section, as I told, offers you the 60 degree phase shift. So in order to achieve that equal phase shift, we have to maintain the same value for these three capacitors, and similarly for these three resistors R3, R4 and R5. So whatever the value will be, these capacitors C1, that will be C2 and C3, similarly for R3. And the expression for the phase shift oscillator, the expression for the frequency of oscillation for phase shift oscillator is omega is equals to 1 over root over 6 times R times C. And why is root 6? Because in general, if you use n number of sections, so in that case the expression should appear as 1 over root over 2 times n times r times c. So here I'm going to use the three sections, so 2n, n equals to 3, so root over 6, and r times c here. Any, if you consider any of these r, so either r3 or c1 or r4 c2 or R5 C3, so any of the R you can consider. But due to presence of this R1, which is connected between the same terminal where the R5 is connected, and the other terminal of the R1 is connected with the virtual ground, which has the equal potential zero as the other terminal of the R5, which is connected with the actual ground. So basically, this R1 and R5 both are appearing parallel to each other because of this virtual ground and due to this actual ground. You can assume these are virtually parallel, but the parallel value will be added over here. So although you are using the different values for this R1 and R5, whereas you are using the equal values for R5, R4 and R3, but R3, R4 and R5, they will not be equal because of the presence of this R1 register, which will appear parallel to this R5. And that will, due to that factor, your circuit is not going to work. So that's why there's a solution. The solution is, I just need to remove this R5 and I need to use this R1. Now here, R1 will serve two purposes. One, it is appearing across this terminal, that means across the capacitor terminal, and to the virtual ground. That means virtually you can assume that it is connected in between these capacitor end to the ground. So it is serving the feedback, serving one of the resistance in this feedback path, as well as this R1 resistance. When being associated with this R2 resistance, it will be used as one of the resistor for achieving the condition of oscillation. So I will show you over here. Now, first of all, I have to decide what will be our frequency of oscillation. Like the previous one, that means the Weinberg oscillator, here also I'm going to design this circuit to get the 5 kilohertz of the frequency of oscillation. So right now I'm going to start the Maxima. I do prefer to use this particular software, the Maxima, because I found this one is comfortable rather than using any calculator. Although Maxima is not for so simple calculations, later on you will see the Maxima can handle larger equations, and it can solve linear equations also, the number of linear equations also. So it's very beautiful software. So, and that's why I do prefer to use this Maxima software for even for a simple calculations. So here C equals to, in Maxima, equals to is actually signified by this colon. C equals to 1 over root 6, so SQRT 6, because I have used the 3 sections times 2 times pi. I can also write pi. In my last literal, you have seen that I have written pi as 32/7, but here also this is another approach using which you can use the pi, or you can use even any mathematical symbol if you place a percentage symbol before that mathematical sign. So 2 pi f is equals to 5 kilohertz. Now the resistance. So what will be the value of the resistance? So here I'm going to assume the value of the resistance, and from that I'm going to calculate the value of the capacitor. Now what will be the value of the resistance? That depends, because look at here, for phase shift oscillator, the condition of oscillation states that the R2 resistance should be 29 times larger than this resistance. Okay, so it will be A beta is equals to 1 over 29. We know these things. So that's why if you are interested to go through the theory of a phase shift oscillator, the link is provided in my description box. You can go to that. Okay, so there I have explained why it is 29 times greater than this R1 resistance. Everything is explained over here. So, and what is R1? R1 is, as I told, is serving two purposes. It is associating with the C3. It is serving the purpose of the third RC sections, which will offer you 60 degree phase shift. So that's why R1 must be equals to R4 and R3. Now, if I'm going to choose R3 with a very larger value, then automatically R1 will be a larger one, because it should be equal to each other. But if R1 will be larger, then 29 times of this R1, that will be the value for R2. And you can imagine, even if you consider it is R1 is 10K or 5K, so 10K means it's 290K, so large value, so high value of this R2 you have to apply. So that's why, in order to avoid that thing, I'm just assuming that R1, R4 and R3 is just 1K. Therefore, 1E3. okay, and look at here the symbolic representation of this expression, and I can get the numerical value by typing this command, this new, yeah, percentage here. It signifies the last answer. What I have obtained, the last answer is this one, which contains the symbols, and numer is the key that states that I want this expression in numerical form or in decimal form. And here the result is appearing as 1.299 into minus 3, or I can consider it as approximately 13 nanofarads. So capacitor is appearing as 13 nanofarad. Well, so I'm writing it 13 nano. This is 1K. This is 1K. And this is 1K and this is 29K. Well, and the transient response is as it is. So I'm simulating and look at here. No output, no oscillation. Similar to the Weinberg oscillator. There also, when I have I put the value of the R2 exactly equals to the theoretical value, that means R2 was the 2 times equals to the R1, I didn't get any result for the Weinberg oscillator also. See, here also I'm not getting that thing. And the theory behind is that the input, the feedback signal should be a bit greater than the idle one, and that's why I need to put a bit larger value for, instead of this 29K, I'm considering it is 34K. Okay. Look at here. As I have placed the 34K, the oscillation has started, and clearly the transient states are, you can see the transient states over here. Okay. And the oscillation is increasing and going to reach the steady state value. And if I increase the observation window starting from 40 to 50 to 52, so 40 millisecond to 52 millisecond, I'm going to observe. So there you can see, look at here, see the oscillation. Okay, so clearly as I have increased the observation window, I can clearly see the transient state as well as the steady state, where the oscillation is clearly visible in between the plus and 10 volt, where plus and plus 10 and minus 10 volt are the positive and negative supply for this circuits. One thing I should mention over here, that you may have noticed that in case of Weinberg oscillator that I have discussed in my previous tutorial, there I also need to put this value a bit larger, but that value was very close to the ideal one. That means R2, theoretically R2 should be 2 and R1 should be 1, or the ratio should be the 2, but I put 2.1 and I have achieved the oscillation for the small increase in this R2. But here the theoretical value is 29K, but I need to put a 34K, so large value I need to put it over here. So why here I need a larger resistance compared with the Weinberg oscillator? Because Weinberg oscillator is a balanced circuit, okay, and in case of balanced circuit, if you will make a little imbalance over there, so we can get the oscillation. Because theoretically, or not theoretically, practically also, the oscillation gets generated from the noisy nature of the source, okay, but in case of a balanced circuit, that noisy nature gets cancelled if the circuit is balanced. If you make a little bit imbalance about that, that noisy nature appears and the oscillation appears much more earlier if you compare with the ideal case also. But in this case, the phase shift oscillator is not a balanced one, so that's why I need to put a larger value compared to the Weinberg oscillator. So this was the tutorial and the design flow of the phase shift oscillator. You can play with the various resistors over here, and you can design your own oscillator by changing the values of R and C, and you can play with that. And in my next tutorial, I will discuss the usage of 555 timer IC, where I will design the astable and monostable multivibrator. Till then, thank you very much.